Hello everyone, and welcome back for another episode of Satellite Rain. In the last episode, we went into Wyvern Inc. very briefly, and I found out I can hijack drones and scuttlebutts, which is kind of cool. We're working on improving our skills, and we've got more to do with Wyvern Inc. in just a moment. So, I think, let's bring up the map and see where we're going. Regrouping at the main entrance, you say, if we're going for the Black Market Cyber Clinic. That sounds quite reasonable. Fast travel, let's do that. Let's zoom out again as well, because as much as I love seeing how awesomely cool my people look... my dude's got a Tron disc on his back. That's how cool he is.
So last time, we infiltrated using our infiltrator. This time, I think we're going to try and do it more, well, aggressively.
Do you want me to blow up with grenades?
I've got grenades that do more damage than your grenades.
What? Oh, don't stand around here and throw grenades. They'll come around and try and find you. This is my hidey place.
I'm just going to make this easier for the future. Also, don't be here.
How much don't be here? Oh, you barely hurt it.
I hurt it quite a lot.
I could throw a grenade and get both of them.
If you want. I do have one more grenade.
Let's do it with my support person because...
Ooh, body armor is complete. Didn't even kill one.
Oh, I killed the door, which is more than you did.
Let's have a look.
I learned this technique from watching The Hunger Games Part 2, Mockingjay Part 2. Set off one bomb, then when people come to investigate, set off another.
Ah, I need to get closer to a relay beacon to do this. Fine, we should be back in just a moment.
Alright, I'm gonna hack this dude who's standing out in the open because he's an idiot.
While you're doing that, I'm hacking my way out of the compound.
Wait, what now?
Because the door had locked.
Cool, I got a dude. Not that we need a dude to get through the doors anymore, but I've got a dude. It's a shame you can't change his name. What's his info? Oh, so you can check to see what their stats are before you send them back for cloning. That's kind of cool.
Yeah, that's kind of the whole point in scanning them in advance.
Oh, yeah, I know. I understood you could do that, but I didn't realize you could do it once you had them selected. Well, once you had them hijacked. So there is a floaty drone, there's a scuttlebutt, and there's a walking tank in here. There's not a huge amount. We could probably just breeze through if you wanted.
Sure.
That's not quite what I meant, but...
Consider breezed.
Alright, distraction.
Oh, that's our tank.
Yeah.
No. To see.
No, not our tank. My dude's the one further in. And you've been arrested.
Yeah.
So do you need to get an infiltrator into the restricted area, or can it be anyone?
Don't know. Honestly, don't know at this stage.
I will try it with mine just as soon as these guys have cleared out. I mean, they're quite serious about securing this non-gate now.
Ah, hello there, Imperial Rising. Good to have you watching the stream.
Yeah, they're incredibly cautious over what's going on here, and they've so nearly found me, but haven't quite.
Well, I'm still being frog marched out of there, so I'm going to watch you. Where are you?
Oh, I'm about to get spotted. If we get spotted,
you're still just in your hiding
place. Right, run for it!
I'm going to get another grenade.
Cool, we're actually going to make it in there. I don't know what we get for getting a support and a research person in there. Oh, sorry, and a hacker in there, but... Got a prototype!
Well, that's all we needed. I've just hacked the main entrance.
Okay,
I'm... will keep it hacked so that you can exfiltrate if you want.
Trying to exfiltrate! Running! We're gonna get
this
so shot.
Not... Yeah. doesn't look like you're doing very well.
So we didn't get the prototype out. But in theory, it's closer.
Man, this looks bad.
What, the number of things there? Yeah, that's what happens when you start to... That's not going to help.
It looks pretty helped.
Did you actually kill him or... No, you didn't. Second one did.
Guys go down. Me! Escape! You hack that. Said, oh.
Terminator 3. Terminator 3, awesome film. Alright, let's respawn these. And yeah, this is a little bit dystopian future Skynet-esque with the flying drones, I suppose. Okay, it looks like they are actually clearing out of there, so I'm going to adopt my normal hidey-hidey position. Oh, once I've rehacked this. That's my hidey place you're in.
Yeah, I'm going after the prototype with my infiltrator, seeing as that's what they're designed for.
I'm afraid I don't know what the rating for this game is, Dark Shadow. I'm sure that if there is a PEGI rating for it, then it'll be on the Steam, on the Steam website, and the link for that will be in the description for the main video when it goes up. But it's called Satellite Rain. Don't worry, I'm gonna hack that fly drone thing. Oh, actually, let's run back. You do a runner.
Cause distraction. Cause a distraction.
A distraction? Like this?
Yep. Nice. Good distraction. Yeah, I'm not liking these shotguns, truth be told.
I really like them against everyone except armored people. And then they don't seem to be effective. Ah, nearly made it to the door. But it was worth it to get the prototype out, I suppose. Cause a distraction, cause a distraction.
Well, you know, it's all teamwork, yeah?
Yes, I will sacrifice myself so that you can get out.
Oh, we found some leg biofibers and an Atlas full leg replacement. They sound awesome.
Well,
was not joking about getting cybernetics out there, so I'm going to start these researching.
So I'm wondering whether we can break in again and get more prototypes and stuff.
Possibly. Ooh, I'm just having a look at what they do. Ah, interesting. So the Atlas for leg replacement allows anybody to use high vents.
Oh.
Which is normally an infiltration only skill. And the leg biofibers increase health and armor, which is very nice.
I see. Oh, that's really cool. So they would go under loadout and augmentation. Okay.
Yeah.
We don't have...
While you're refitting your guys, you might want to give yourself some body armor.
That's under gear? Oh, yeah, yes. We've got body armor now. So, yeah. Purchase. I keep double clicking instead of hitting purchase. I think that's one thing that the interface could do with. But just I understand...
Small QOL improvements like that.
I understand why they don't do it, though. Do you want to give John Bengston to your soldier dude?
Let's have a look. Loadout, clone, John Bengston. Ooh, he's got a lot of health.
He's got a lot of health. Also, there's Hamish Freighter, but I'm going to give him to my hacker.
Yeah, okay.
And then I'm going to do the accuracy one. So Viola Moss on my support.
Right, I'm just going to scrap some of these older ones. Basically anything with only 5 health bonus.
Oh my god, he looks so silly. Now what can I do for colours for him? Oh, he's changing like that.
And Buffy as well.
And this one's changing like that. Yeah. Cool. So, my hacker looks really depressed. If you have a look at his mugshot on the little bottom thumbnails, he looks like he's having his worst day ever.
Actually, he looks a bit like that just in the 3D view as well.
Okay, so we've been into that cybernetics bit within Wyvern. Let's bring up mission control.
Now we're up to the Continental Haven,
which is in the same area, but even further back.
Yeah.
Oh, and there's automated sentry turrets in there. What? But looks like we might be able to get in through round the corner.
We could also pay for some information on this mission. Shall I do that?
We've got money, so I guess we may as well.
Oh gosh, there's lots of info. The south entrance is a death trap unless you are fully prepared for a fight. The east side looks safer, but only if you stay on track. There's a slip entrance on the eastern wall of the storage yard. That's how I exfiltrated last time, actually. Basically, it's just saying this is really, really tough. You either need to go in hard or go in smart.
And we're not smart or hard.
Where are you going?
I'm heading up round the side because apparently there's another way in just up here. It looks like there might be a secondary entrance.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
So I thought I would scout out and see what I could see. There's a big camera control over here at the back. But I think that's not where we're trying to get to. That's a lift which will take us up to the next level. But if we can get in from up here kind of thing.
Yeah, well, that security thing that's at the bottom of the stairs that you just went up. That opens the door next to it.
Oh, I see. So we could sneak in. Oh, wow. Good job you're paying attention. I've got hijack level, hack level 3, so I can totally do this.
Right, we're coming as well.
It looks like it may be one way, though. Like, entirely one way, because it's...
Oh. Yes, it could be. That's fine. There's an exfiltration on the other side. There's no problem at all, I'm sure. Disclaimer, not entirely sure.
Right, if I get this hacked, I can get my support person up in there while I'm waiting for you. Yeah, so for an ever so slight, tiny moment, the area becomes free and clear. The lift becomes free and clear when you're moving through. But otherwise, we can't go back that way.
We're infiltrating up towards Continental Haven.
Okie dokie. I'll come around and do the same, because those cameras are going to be out forever.
There's separate cameras inside Continental Haven, by the way.
That's all right. It's only a hack level 1 up this way. Are you hardwiring? Oh, look at you.
I am. Yeah. Got skills and everything.
I'm keeping
out
the camera.
We've got a long way to infiltrate still. I think this is just for the door. Yeah.
Right, let's bring up this. So there's a hard line, a hard wire around the side, which will affect a whole load of cameras and other stuff. You might want to go and do that.
I don't have hard wiring level 2, but I can blow the shit out of it.
Well, that will just draw people. So let's have a look and see if we can do it smart. We could just run on in and I'll cause a distraction, killing everything while you charge into the main Continental Haven.
I don't really like the sound of that plan, truth
okay.
be told. Okay.
In that case, where do these cameras go to? I think they're all the way at the back and at the top. Just at the very, very edge of my worldview vision.
Oh yes, I see. Yeah.
So how would I get to there? That's a vent to get up there. which is a low vent, which is fine, but I'd need to get over to that side. So I'm going to start infiltrating over that way. Let's see where these patrol groups go.
Maybe I can slowly get my infiltrator to just get over there.
Well, that's kind of what I'm going to do. And if I can get behind this wall, I can probably run on up in a moment and go through that vent and disable all the cameras if I sneak behind them. But I need to time it well. Like when everything's gone and is not looking towards me. And those people at the top of the stairs are annoying. Stop walking towards the top of the stairs, guys.
Ah, damn it. I'm almost in.
Well, I'm going to disable the cameras for your... I don't think I can use vents at all, actually. Oh, no. No, I can. It's just you need to actually click on them. So, we're going to disable the security cameras.
Well, that makes my exfiltration a lot easier.
And then I can zipline back down out if I want. I want one of these guys to come up so I can steal them. But I'm also just happy staying up here. I can throw grenades off the edge from out. That might be fun. Right, let's do it one at a time. So we're being sensible about this. Grenade. There!
What are you doing?
I'm throwing a grenade off the edge of a building. What are you doing?
Hiding at the moment.
That's one camera gone.
You could probably have shot that from there.
Probably. Not with the shotgun, though. But it does draw everyone in, and then I can throw another grenade down like this. Assassination successful.
Oh, nice.
That was completely accidental.
That's actually a side mission that we were not really looking to do, but fantastic. Good work.
No.
So that's going to make it cheaper for us to get out of downtown, I believe.
As much as we try not to throw too much profanity into games, we do occasionally swear, so apologies for that, but you get what you pay for with us, and you don't pay, so enjoy.
Don't come up here. I really wanted to get over that bridge.
Alright, so I haven't even looked at how I'm going to be... like exiting. Is it through that lift on the right hand side?
Not entirely sure. A bit focused on myself getting almost discovered. Okay. No, I can look at you now. Right. You're there, going over to that building.
I think
to that lift.
So
yeah, that holographic tree is what you're aiming for. Down to your bottom right.
Okay. I think I know where I'm going.
Oh, this is all very dramatic.
I know.
Like, it's a double-pronged exfiltration. It's...
This is like, still a restricted area, though, isn't it?
What, where the holographic tree is?
Yeah.
Probably. I didn't
yes, it
go
is.
That way when I was getting out.
Right, hacking the drone caught. That's actually seen me. Hopefully before these guys turn around and spot me. Uh-oh. The drone caused enough of a distraction for us to mostly get away.
Good work.
As long as they don't follow us around here, we might be able to get... Oh my god, this is where you died horribly.
Are you sure? I don't think you're anywhere that I've been... Oh, yes. From here, head southeast exactly.
Up the stairs.
Just straight across the road. Yeah, straight across the road to where that exit point is that's just been highlighted. Let yourself get arrested. It's fine.
No way, I don't want them to beat me up. We're just going.
Unfortunately, you've made it harder for me to get out now because that was my exfiltration point.
Hey, what can I say? I mean, I made it through an extra restricted area bit to get there. I could... Oh no, I don't have any more grenades.
It's fine, I'll cope. I'll figure something out.
Besides, if I can run across without any, like, training or skill or anything, I'm sure you can do just as well. Oh, there you are. Hello.
Yeah, we're almost out.
Which way did you go to be able to come in from that direction? I mean, hell, where?
Through the entire compound. It was really quite impressive.
I'm sure it was. All right, well, let's steal this guy. He's going to spot me.
Hey, I'm going to call for backup.
That's okay. I'm gone. With my friend. So I'm going to call this one Robert. And I'm not going to send him for cloning. He's going to stick with us. So... The closest relay beacon, is that what you need?
No, we just need to run and hide now until we're not
being followed. Oh, well, that's easy.
Don't go that way, there's a guard. Get out of sight. Get out of sight.
I'm backing up.
There we go. Stealth generator Mark 1 and biocranial plating. Those are going to be fun. I'm guessing stealth generator gives everyone the ability to cloak, which is going to be amazing.
That would be very cool.
The cranial bioplating, I have no idea. I guess head armor, possibly?
Cranial bioplating is a prototype head augmentation, increases health and armor.
Research, yes. Yeah, so very much like the biofibers for the leg, I guess.
Yeah. Oh, I'm looking forward to the full leg replacements.
And stealth generator. Basically gives everyone stealth.
Cool.
Just obviously not as good as
the infiltrator. That's another scientist.
Get him.
Oh, no, wrong button. Do not select person 5.
You get the scientist. Bang.
Cool, we've got another scientist.
Hey. That's going to make things ever so slightly cheaper for us in the long run. I mean, not right now, but yes.
Yeah, it's worth bringing up worldview periodically just to see what, because it highlights them in yellow on the map as well as on the main view. And of course, all the bribing gets a little bit cheaper. Is that another one? It is. Got us another. That's 3 this evening that we've picked up. BioLeg Fibers research has been completed.
Oh, fantastic.
Good to have you on the stream, Stinger Stealers. This is Satellite Rain. It's a dystopian future cyberpunk Syndicate Wars style Blade Runner-esque corporate espionage hacking infiltration game, for want of a better way of putting it. It's good fun. And I am thoroughly enjoying it, and surprisingly tense at times.
It's basically tense all the time. I think I got some more skill points, actually. Let's have a look. Loadout. Skills. 1 skill point and 4. Okay, so I can get Master Thief now so that I can use High Vent. That's going to be very good. And then I can't afford anything else.
No, then no one can afford anything because you're going to be spending all of your stuff on the loadouts as well. It was a little bit of a mouthful, but it's probably the best way to explain it without missing out part of it. There's a lot to this game, despite how simple it looks and how easy it is to pick up and play. Oh, the full leg replacement's done. There's a lot of subtle elements to it because there's different character classes, and because Matryx and I am playing multiplayer, I've got the support person, which allows worldview, which can show when cameras are linked up to different access panels and doors are linked up to security nets and things like that. And I've also got the hacker who can then actually break into them. And Matryx has got the infiltrator, who can actually turn invisible, proper stealth. And the soldier, who is much beefier and tankier than everyone else. And you have two grenades.
Yes, because I'm an explosives expert.
Oh.
And my grenades do 10% more damage than yours.
I can't help but feeling that that's a little bit unfair, given how much I love grenades. Also, our money is rapidly, like, vanishing.
Yeah, that's because I'm starting more research on different things.
Oh, okay. As long as it's intentional rather than just we're running out. Satellite rain. Go. That's the name.
R&D cost 14 per second, and the ATM siphons are getting us almost 3 per second. So only... we've got a net loss of 11 per second.
Only 3? I could have sworn we had more than that.
No. We did.
Oh, $0.27 per second. All right, so, yeah, the various ATMs are somewhat less lucrative than I expected.
Yeah, the higher ranked ones, I think, do slightly better. What's your hacking level at the moment?
At the moment, my hacking level is 3 now.
There's one up at the bank that we could get then, because there was a 3 and a 5.
Yeah,
there.
So that'll certainly help. And the bank was around here, I think. Yeah, that's the bank. So let's... Oh, you just fast travel. Oh, well, that's easy.
Yeah.
I mean, that's like planning ahead. I think it is a PC-only game, but...
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is. So if you're a consoler, then I'm sorry, you're out of luck. Now, I could probably just stand right next to it on the side, out of sight of the camera, and hack it from there.
Or you could disable the cameras from around here.
Let's see if it could potentially see
yes,
me.
Yes, it can.
Yes, it can, definitely.
I mean, you probably got enough time to do it before it swings back, but why risk it?
Yeah. And that is the right control panel for those cameras. Oh, yeah, it knocks them out for absolutely ages. Now.
Yep.
The chance for my hacker to do the other one is 33%, so I'm going to give that a go as well, just in case.
Fine. Then I'm going away because the police will arrive.
Only if I fail.
Which is quite likely.
Captain Guard can kind of like stand here and pretend that he's like here to arrest me or something. Nope, that didn't work.
I can hear alarms.
It's fine. It's all fine. It's really nice that we've got body armor now, though. Right, I'm going to give that one more go before they turn up. They're coming from behind. Guardy, distract him.
Guardy.
Well, I was going to call him Robert, and then I thought Guardy is a more appropriate name. Yes, I'm definitely going to get the Necromancer expansion for Diablo 3 when it does come out. It's something I've been looking forward to for a while, well, basically since they announced it. Alright, hack successful that time.
Oh, I just broke in down here again.
Hacking the floaty drone. Oh, no, no, we're getting shot to death.
Yeah, I just broke into Dracogenic again just to rob some more money.
Oh, you can do that. Cool.
Yeah.
Well, in that case, why don't we go into the bank again?
Sure. Let's give that a go. Once you're no longer wanted, 3-star almost.
Trust me, they were annoyed with me.
You had your weapons out. I'm not surprised. I suppose I should ask, like, what you did to piss them off, but
well,
I'm not sure I want to know.
I hacked into the terminal 4 times, and I succeeded on the last one, but in order to give me enough time, Guardy had to, kill everyone that came near. So there was at least 4 murders.
Right.
And then
at
a failed...
four murders.
And then a failed hacking attempt of a drone, and, yeah. By that point, I had 3 stars. I'm going to get the floaty drone that's sort of following up behind you, though. I have to say, I love being able to hijack these.
I love being able to stealth.
Oh, they spotted you.
Yep, they have. I'll just let myself get arrested. Oh no, you can't see me now.
Because you stealthed. That's very cool.
Nope, ran out of stealth. Basically, not enough energy. But I think I have confused them.
Well, floaty drone took out one camera to help.
Yeah. Definitely going to get more guards coming this way, but that's fine. We don't have much more to go. They can see me.
Yeah.
They can see you.
I know, because I'm stealing one of the guards.
Which means they can see me.
Sorry, Guardy's doing his thing. Oh my god, you threw a grenade.
He was calling for reinforcements. I couldn't let him do that.
So,
worth it.
Problem solved.
We are still stealth. This is still technically stealth. Everyone who has seen us is dead.
Oh, camera.
Oh, what are you doing?
Still stealth.
Now they're coming out. I just heard gates open.
Well, it didn't have a chance to call for reinforcements.
Here we go. Watch our cash. 508-ish. No, 480. 460. 452. Ta-ding!
I'm going to send my people in just to see if we get any benefit from it at all.
You idiot! Stop running in front of cameras! Don't do that! Oh.
Still stealth. Still totally stealth. I suspect we're not going to get anything after you robbed it just like immediately. Yeah, we didn't get anything.
I like how you sent the guard in to rob the place as well.
Oh yeah, that's important. Well, that didn't quite go according to plan. Damn scuttlebutts. Uh-oh. It's fine, it's all fine.
Well, I've cleared the path to get out.
I'm stealing another guard. And I think he's the last one that's left alive in here with us. They are all my friends. This is how you do hacking.
Ah. Yeah, so I killed like 4 or 5 guards down here.
Good job.
Yeah. I only used one grenade on them as well.
Look at you being all soldiery.
Ah, soldier.
Well, I would say that was a successful little excursion. I am going to send both of these guards back for cloning before they die. Off you go, Guardy and Guardy 2. Interesting that your armour doesn't repair over time, although I suppose that's to be expected, isn't it?
It does, actually.
Oh, does it?
Oh, I see. Yeah, it just ticks up really slowly.
Yeah. Yeah, it's faster, I think, if you're within range of the relay beacon.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Yes, much faster. So, after that rather successful bank job, far more successful than the first time we did it, although all of our cash has also actually disappeared again since because we're researching so heavily, that's going to be enough for this episode. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed this as much as we have. Remember to like these videos if you'd like them, and as always, subscribe to our channels if you haven't already, and we will see you again soon for more Satellite Rain.
We'll see you soon.